Hey, it's Professor Dave. I want to tell you about the human body.
He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
There are many reasons why someone might want to learn science. You could master physics and chemistry in order to make new materials and build useful machines. You could learn about astronomy and unravel the mysteries of the universe. But one extremely practical application involves learning about the human body. With some background knowledge in the physical sciences, it becomes possible to learn about all the complex systems present in animal species, including humans. And with that knowledge, one can truly begin to understand medicine and nutrition and countless other areas of universal interest. How is the human body organized, and how does it function? What are its components, and what are those made of? As complicated as the human body is, these questions have answers, and anyone can understand them if they put in a little effort. Of course, as we mentioned, the ability to understand the human body requires a significant amount of background knowledge. Everything inside of us, whether the heart or the brain or any other organ, is made of certain kinds of tissue. These tissues are made of cells, which we study in biology. These cells are made of large biomolecules, like proteins and DNA, which we study in biochemistry. And these biomolecules are made of atoms, which we study in general chemistry. So while it is certainly possible to memorize a lot of facts about the human anatomy without any of this prerequisite knowledge, the only way to gain a deep understanding is to take care of those subjects first. Luckily, I have you covered for all of those and more, so if you need some review, check out my other playlists and get yourself up to speed. If you're all set regarding atoms and molecules and cells, then you're ready to climb up to the next rung on the ladder of complexity and begin to learn about multicellular life. There are millions of multicellular species on Earth, and perhaps in a future zoology course, we can look at a whole bunch of them. But in this series, we will focus on one particular species, Homo sapiens, because that's us. We are part of the kingdom Animalia, which means we are animals. We belong to the phylum Chordata, and specifically the subphylum Vertebrata, which means we have a spinal column. We are in the class Mammalia, which means we are mammals, with features such as hair on our heads and skin. We are part of the order Primates, which means we have big brains. We belong to the family Hominidae, which are the great apes. And finally, we are the last surviving members of the genus Homo, which means man. And our species is called sapiens. All the other animals on the tree are fascinating in their own way. But we spend lots of time studying ourselves so that we can better understand the human body and the amazing things it can do. In this series, we will move through the human body one component at a time, focusing on anatomy, or biological form, as well as physiology, or biological function, and we will slowly build towards a complete understanding of how these systems work together to produce a viable human being. That means examining the different types of tissue we all possess, and then bones and muscles, as these are some of the basic structural components within us. Then we will look at each major system, including nervous, endocrine, circulatory, respiratory, digestive, immune, and others. Each of these serves a critical function in maintaining our health, so we have to know how they work on both the cellular and molecular level. Given that we talk about our bodies quite a bit on a day-to-day basis when discussing what to eat or how to exercise, it is very likely that you will have heard about many of these body parts before, some of them as early as childhood. But in this series, we will go beyond a casual memorization of facts. We have to connect this information to the abstract world of atoms and molecules so that we can produce a seamless continuum of knowledge from the microscopic world all the way to the macroscopic. Once we are through here, you will be able to look at your own hands and imagine all the tiers of reality that operate within them. This is the kind of holistic knowledge that allows for critical thinking, not just a memorization of facts, but the ability to take in new information and integrate it with existing knowledge regarding biological systems. So if you're ready to change the way you see yourself in the mirror, let's learn some anatomy and physiology. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.